Hi, I'm Eiji, and I'm a developer advocate at Google. Today, I'm going to give you an overview of Web Components. Web Components are a set of emerging standards that changes the way you develop web apps entirely. They will enable you to build and reuse UI components when building web applications. Let's take a look at how you might build a UI element today and how that process can be improved by using Web Components. Here is a nice-looking chart. How would you build this using HTML, CSS, and JavaScript? It must be a bit of work if you create this from scratch. To help us build our chart, we can use the Google Visualization API. First, load the Google JavaScript library to use the API. Then add a div tag onto the body as a placeholder. Now, using JavaScript, initialize the library by loading Visualization API. Then set the values and the options at callback. Finally, specify the DOM element to append the chart graphic. OK, now let's dive into the Web Components approach and see how that drastically changes the way you build the chart. With Web Components, first thing you should do is to import Google Chart component. To enable unsupported browsers to work, you will also need to load an open source polyfill called platform.js. Then add Google Chart tag and fill in the attributes as you wish. And done. Did you notice the difference between those two approaches? Yes, the first one was imperative using JavaScript. The second one was declarative using HTML tag. The declarative approach might look easier to handle, but the biggest difference here is not easy or difficult. It is the underlying knowledge required for developer to use those APIs. In the original example, the first thing you have to do is to understand how Google JavaScript library works. Then you can learn how to use the APIs to control it. On the other hand, the Web Components approach uses DOM APIs, which most of the web developers are already familiar with. So you can just start by learning how to use attributes and APIs. The difference seems subtle, but you'll notice the benefit when you work with other UI libraries. For example, jQuery UI, Bootstrap, Clojure libraries, etc. all uses different approaches, so you will have to learn them before actually start using them. There are other benefits of using Web Components as well. Let's take a look at them one by one. Scoped. Since Web Components have scoped styles and markup, imported components won't harm any other part of your web page. In existing libraries, there are cases where you have same class names or IDs that potentially overlap with the ones in the library. With Web Components, all markups and CSS are scoped to the element. This means the CSS bundled with the component will not leak out to affect the parent document. And it also prevents the parent document from accidentally styling the component. Reusable. Because Web Components are scoped and decoupled with other parts of your web page, you can use the same component in other part of your web page or even on the other website. Furthermore, you can share the element with the community as open source so that anyone can take advantage of your work. Isolation. Because Web Components are scoped, you can decouple development of UI components from main functionality. Developers are able to independently work on UI components without needing to worry or be aware of the implementation details of other parts on the page. Note that maintaining those components is much easier because of isolation as well. Okay. Web Components sounds like a great solution for serving or using UI components. So how can we actually build our own component? Web components consist of four core technologies: templates, shadow DOM, custom elements, and HTML imports. Let me briefly describe what they are like. Templates allow you to define inert boilerplates for repeatedly used markup inside your HTML. Because the content of the template is inert, it will not request images or run scripts until it is stamped out onto the page. Shadow DOM allows you to associate scoped HTML markup and CSS with an existing DOM element. Since Shadow DOM is encapsulated, the style won't affect anything outside of it. Custom Elements allows you to define and register a custom HTML element as if it were a native element. HTML Imports allow you to load multiple resources such as JavaScript, CSS, and additional HTML files by loading a single HTML. Combining all those technologies will look something like this. First, prepare an HTML file that is separate from main HTML. Define and register a custom element. Associate Shadow DOM onto it. Use templates to provide contents of the Shadow DOM. Finally, import the component HTML file using HTML import. Now you have the basic idea of web components. I'm going to post a series of videos about web components features so you can learn how to use them. In the meantime, documents and resources listed here will help you learn more about web components, so please check them out. All right, thank you for watching. See you in the next episode.